بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على خاتم الأنبياء والمرسلين وعلى آله وأصحابه والتابعين ومن تبعهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين. أما بعد، truly all praises belong to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the creator, the sustainer, excuse me, the creator, the sustainer, and the controller of all that happens in the universe. And we invoke his peace and blessings upon his noble messenger, his family, his companions, and all those who follow them in righteousness until the end of time. My dear brothers and sisters in Islam, assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. We all know that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has sent the Prophet alayhi salatu wa salam as a bearer of glad tidings and as a warner. He's not just bringing good news, he's not just a warner, but a combination of the two. Bringer of glad tidings, of course, obviously refers to the good news that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has for people who choose to believe and to submit and surrender and strive to do what is good, inasmuch as they may make mistakes from time to time. And so Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala not only has given us good news, but he has in some cases given us some details about paradise in particular and the various levels of bliss and enjoyment that a person who is in paradise will enjoy. In addition to that, though, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has also given us the good news about his forgiveness and his mercy, and that he's always ready and always willing and always there to turn to anyone who turns to him. He will turn to anyone who turns to him. But the catch is, brothers and sisters, it is not Allah who will turn first. It is the individual who has to turn first. The individual who has to make the first move and initiate the change. This is why the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam tells us in a hadith that the Imam Bukhari relates in his Sahih that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, O son of Adam, O human being, if you were to turn to me and come to me with sins the size of the distance between the heavens and the earth, I will meet you with the same amount of forgiveness. Not half of it, not some of it, all of it, with the same size of forgiveness. But the key condition is, if you read the hadith carefully, is that the human being has to first turn towards Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. In the same hadith, which is a hadith Qudsi by the way, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala informs us and gives us the good news of how much he really wants to forgive us. But we have to do something to be deserving of that. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the same hadith, O human being, if you come to me walking, I will come to you running. If you come to me tamshi, walking, I will come to you uharwil, I will run, I will jog, faster than walking, in other words. But again, the key condition is you have to come to Allah walking. So this is also a type of good news that the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam brought, in that a person should not despair or ever lose hope of the mercy and the grace and the forgiveness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But at the same time, the person needs to realize that the mercy of Allah and the grace of Allah will not just fall into your lap, but we have to do something. And so we have to make the first move. And then Allah the Exalted, out of His mercy and compassion, will meet us not even just halfway, but more than halfway. Now in this sort of background, I'd like to share with you a hadith that Shaykh Al-Albani graded as sahih, in which the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam again offers a lot of good news for us. He said, لَوْ عَلِمْتُمْ If you people knew, in reality, if you truly knew the reward that is kept hidden for you, مَا حَزِنْتُمْ عَلَى مَا زُوِيَ عَنْكُمْ, you will never ever be sorry for the things that miss you. If you only knew the reward of what has been kept hidden for you, you will never be sad, you will never grieve over the things that you miss, the things that you don't achieve. Now a person may ask, well, if there is all this good that Allah has hidden for us, why doesn't He tell us one time? So that it will make it easier for us to avoid what is wrong and strive for this good. Well, there's a reason why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has not told us of all that is hidden for us in terms of reward for our choices. That is the good reward for the good choices we make. He has given us some information, so He has told us of some things, but not everything. And in the Quran, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, فَلَا تَعْلَمُ نَفْسٌ مَا أُخْفِيَ لَهُمْ مِنْ قُرَّةِ أَعْيُنٍ. No soul knows the realities or truly the things that are kept hidden for them as a reward. Why? جَزَاءً بِمَا كَانُوا يَعْمَلُونَ, as a reward for what they used to do. So here's the thing. The fact that most of these things are hidden from us, but we are told that they're rewards we don't know about, and they're good things we don't know about, we have never seen, we have never heard of, we have not even imagined, as the Prophet ﷺ puts it in the authentic hadith in Sahih Muslim, وَلَا خَطَرَ عَلَىٰ قَلْبِ بَشَرٍ, that he says that there are things, rewards, enjoyment and pleasures that Allah has kept hidden for the people in paradise. مَا لَا عَيْنٌ رَأَتْ, things that no eyes have ever seen. وَلَا أُذُنٌ سَمِعَتْ, nor ears have ever heard of these things. وَلَا خَطَرَ عَلَىٰ قَلْبِ بَشَرٍ, nor has it ever crossed the mind or the thoughts or the imagination of a human being. So, if these things were made known to people, the element of believing in the promise of Allah would no longer be applicable. See, part of our belief as Muslims and part of the foundations of Islam, that as Muslims we subscribe to, is belief and conviction in the promise of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We don't need to actually see these things to believe in them as Muslims, but we should have that belief and conviction. That's why Allah says in Surah Al-Layl, وَاللَّيْلِ إِذَا يَغْشَى, Allah says, فَأَمَّا مَنْ أَعْطَى وَاتَّقَى وَصَدَّقَ بِالْحُسْنَى فَسَنُيَسِّرُهُ لِلْيُسْرَى. As for him who gives, فَأَمَّا مَنْ أَعْطَى, who gives, in charity that is generous, is kind, helps out other people. And the gives here doesn't mean literally money only, right? You can give many other things. You can give of your time. You can give of your knowledge, your skill, your expertise, your experience, your advice. You can give, of course, wealth. You can share your food. So there are many things you can give. فَأَمَّا مَنْ أَعْطَى وَاتَّقَى, so as for him who gives, that he shares with others, whatever you can share, whether it is your time, your skill, your knowledge, anything that you can share with, share. وَاتَّقَى, and is conscious about Allah so much so as to avoid doing what is prohibited. I know ittaqa here is translated as fear, but the fear really is the fear of the punishment of Allah in cases of disobedience. So this fear of the punishment in case of disobedience should motivate the person to avoid these acts of disobedience. Then Allah says in the next verse, وَصَدَّقَ بِالْحُسْنَى, and the person believes in the husna, that is the good reward Allah has promised. We haven't seen it, no one has seen it, so no one is able to tell us exactly what it is. We have been been informed a little bit about it by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the Quran and of course in the hadith. But we haven't been given all the information about it, but we believe in it. And we should have conviction that this is true and this is real. So if Allah were to tell us everything about everything that's hidden, that concept of believing in the promise of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, trusting fully that Allah fulfills His words and He never breaks His promise as God, and that He's always just and always fair, and that He never does any injustice to anyone, then this concept would have no meaning. But what Allah wants us to do is to be motivated, to show an interest in striving for this great reward without being told everything about it. Just a little bit. Just a little bit. And subhanAllah, brothers and sisters, even with the little bit that we know of the reward of Jannah, it is more than enough to make it worthwhile for anybody to strive very hard to achieve this. Even that little bit, subhanAllah, is so much really in the end. But the hadith says that if you knew fully what Allah has kept hidden for you, so more than the things we know, no one will ever be sad about anything. No, you will never be sad about anything. You will never be sad about anything that misses you. That is the tremendous reward that Allah has kept hidden for us. And so we should not lose focus, brothers and sisters, as we live in this life and we experience the ups and the downs of life. We should not lose focus of the reward that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has prepared and has promised. And He does not go back on His promise. We know that for sure, without any doubt, period, in the Quran. وَلَن يُخْلِفَ اللَّهُ وَعْدَهُ. And Allah will never break His promise. God Almighty does not behave in that way. وَمَنْ أَصْدَقُ مِنَ اللَّهِ قِيلًا. And who is truer in speech or in promises than Allah? No one else. So we should never lose focus and lose sight of this tremendous reward, because this, inshallah, is one of the things that will help us to help lift our spirits, help to lift our morale when we experience the downs in life. The ups, mashallah, we're happy as it is. But it's when we experience the downs that people feel depressed and stressed out. This is when we need something to lift our spirits. And this, remembering the promise of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and the fact that He has kept hidden for us much more than the little He has told us about. Yet the little that He's told us about is a lot. This should bring some happiness and some comfort to anyone who feels down and feels stressed out and feels anxious and worried about the cons of this life and the difficulties that we go through as part of the cycle of life itself. So this is part of the good news that the Prophet ﷺ brought for us as believers, that the reality is we will go through ups and downs in life, but we should never ever lose hope, and we should never despair of the mercy and the forgiveness and the promise of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But our end of the bargain is we have to strive for it. We have to work for it. We have to not only desire it and want it, but we have to do something to get it. We cannot just sit back and expect it's going to fall in our laps. We have to make the first move. So may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless all of us. May He open up our hearts and minds so that we can not only understand this wonderful message that He has revealed, but that we would all be inspired and motivated to hold firmly to it and to live by it. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala cause us to be among those who never lose hope and who never despair of His mercy and His forgiveness. And may He cause us also to be among those who do what we're supposed to do in order to become deserving of the grace and the mercy and the bounty and the forgiveness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Aqulu qawli hadha wa astaghfirullah li wa lakum. Wassalamu alaykum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. just turned us off.
I don't know.
If I come around, we'll turn it on.
Yeah.
What are you doing?